Hi guys, welcome to Black YouTube, a place where accountability is absent, blame is ever present, personal responsibility is a foreign concept, you'll never get balanced commentary, subscribers must follow the lead of the content creator or face being banned. Let us try to figure out what the main message is of Black YouTube. It is broke men telling fat women to lose weight and fat women telling broke men to level up. I promise you that I'll try my best to have balanced commentary. You may not always agree with me. I am open to intellectual debate. Thank you guys. Hi guys, let's talk a little bit about two concepts, multiculturalism and also the melting pot, and how that has impacted black men and black women in different ways, because they've had different outcomes and different reactions to this. So let's take a deep dive into the 1960s. In the 1960s in Jamaica, Jamaica gained independence, and that was important because after gaining independence, there was the emergence now of a black middle class, a burgeoning black middle class. And I think it's similar to what's happened in the US when, you know, after the Civil Rights Act, they had that burgeoning set of people moving into the middle class. That's important because what happened is, as with immigrants, and I want to say that being the fact that the rights of black people before the 60s were compromised, after the 60s, it's almost like an immigrant experience because you're now being welcomed into, you know, more doors and into more places that you've never been before. So the first generation, you normally end up with that first generation having multiculturalism, which is separate cultures. You know, you all are under the same law, but you all have your separate cultures. As time goes on and the next generation comes in, now you have more assimilation where you have the minority culture assimilate into the major culture. It has not been like that. What has happened now is that I saw it in Jamaica, and I think I'm seeing it in Canada and in the US, where the black culture is not only melting into white culture, we are seeing an imprint of black culture on the main American culture, black culture on the main Canadian culture, black culture on the main Jamaican culture. Well, Jamaica black culture is very dominant because it's majority black. So what has happened is now the foods that people eat, the customs that people have, the music that people listen to, it's more similar. That is causing a lot of racial barriers to be reduced. And this is important because as these racial barriers reduce, what we're seeing is the dating market is now a big wide open market. Becoming a big wide open market, black men are faced with several options because of the difference between the dating markets. In the dating market, It's still in a large sector, a provider-based market. Those that can provide the most, they are the ones that can, you know, get women, get mates and partners. And there's also another aspect of those that can be stable partners, faithful partners. They're being prioritized in this partner market for black men and white men and Asian men. On the women's side, there is a difference in that the men are seeking more aesthetically beautiful women, and that standard tends to be very European, and that creates a problem for people who are non-European, and that's what's happening in the dating market right now. Now, there are areas of the dating market where black women are doing well, but what we're seeing by and large, and a lot of people say it's black women's worship of black men. I've heard that over and over. I tend not to believe that. I tend to believe it's not just a worship of black men. I think there's a confidence issue in the sense that I think the image of black women has been so damaged, and I think that there's a lot of gaslighting going on, a lot of browbeating going on, where black women are made to feel less than. And this has been going on for years. We've seen rappers do it, we've seen comedians do it, we've seen focus on weave and makeup and eyelashes and all of these things. Things that are really ungentlemanly that a lot of black men have gone into. And then out of that has become, you know, you have now this wide open market where black women are taking their time to figure out how to engage in the market. Black men, on the other hand, they are rushing into this market and they are exploring their options. And I've heard people say black men haven't built, but something that I think they're not getting, and they're not getting that the infrastructure is built already. What's important now is to maintain that infrastructure and to improve on that infrastructure. So therefore, these black men who are moving to other communities, and they say nesting in these other communities, they are by and large Canadians, Americans, people from the UK who are just enjoying the privileges of any citizen. So to say that these people are not building, I think it's disingenuous, because they're enjoying the melting pot community. And that's an important nuance that people are overlooking, because there's this talk of the black community, but in a melting pot, is there really a black community, or it's a Canadian community, it's an American community? Because when you start to think of it in that way, it is people becoming part of the fabric of a nation. And that is happening before our eyes. And I think that we need to be perceptive to understand that in the next generation, these are going to be a lot of mixed people. People who have two different ethnic backgrounds blended together. So I think it's a little short-sighted to say, hey, these people are black and they're leaving the community and they're nesting in another community. What we need to look at is that a combined community is being formed. Something to think on as we go about this journey in observation. So I plan to cover a little bit on this topic further, because I think that when you understand the melting pot and what it means, and you look at communities like the Greek community, the Italian community, and how they became part of the fabric of even in Canada, and I suspect in the US also, you will see that way back when there was a German community, there was a Dutch community, but they become part of the national fabric. And as they become part of the national fabric, it's not that their original community is destroyed, it is that they're melting into the mainstream. So something to think about. Thanks, guys.